Hello, I welcome you to the demonstration of this bell crank lever setup. Now, with the help of this setup, we will verify the law of moment. Now, for an equilibrium system, the law of moment is defined as the total clockwise moment is equal to the total counterclockwise moment. You can see the setup diagram here. This is the bell crank lever. Now, this lever is connected to this base. It is a rigid base via this string. So we have this spring here, we have this spring balance. Now this is to record the tension in the string. So what we will be doing is, we will use this setup and we will verify that law of moment. Now when we put loads here, we will be putting the loads here. We can put any number of loads. So as you can see in the diagram, here once some load is put at some distance, so this is a pivot point, okay. So we will be adding the loads here, and when we add the loads, there will be some tension in the string. So the whole setup will be in equilibrium. We will assume that this base is rigidly supported, so that means it will not fall down. So once we add the load here, for this equilibrium system, we can find out the moments because of these forces, and we will see which force will create the clockwise moment and anti-clockwise moment. Accordingly, we will verify whether the clockwise moment is equal to the total anti-clockwise moment or not. Now for that, we need to have the free body diagram. So we have the free body diagram here, free body diagram. Now this is the lever, and this is a pivot point. So about this point, we will be taking the moments. So as you can see, one weight is added here, another weight it is added at different distances. We can have any number of weights, any number of values, and also at any distance we can add. So generally we go for two weights or three weights at different distances. And this distance, this vertical distance is fixed, this is y, and for our experiment setup, it is we take this y value as 20 centimeters. And another force is here, this is the tension force in this direction because of this linkage, so this tension force. Now how the readings are taken, how the experiment is performed, this we will I will be demonstrating later. But we can also see, we can see this observation table. We can take different readings just to verify what is the percentage of error coming for different values. Now here you can see we have W1 and W2. This W1 and W2 are the weights which we will be adding on this arm. So there are three weights shown here, we can have another weight also. So two weights are there, so we can write down here whatever the adds weights we add, the values. And now these X1 and X2, these are the distances of weights that are added from the pivot point. For example, you can see here X1 is the distance of W1 from this O, horizontal distance, and X2 is the distance of W2 from the this pivot point or origin. If we have W3, then X3 will also come. So X1, X2 for corresponding W1 and W2. Now here tension in the string. So now here Ti is mentioned. This Ti is initial tension. This is initial tension. This Ti is initial tension. Initial tension means before we add any weights, that I will again explain in the while giving the demonstration. You can see before we add any weights, there may be some tension in the spring. If it is not calibrated to zero, then there will be some tension, either plus or minus. We need to note down that. So that tension we will be recording, and final tension once we add the weights. Again, we will be recording the final tension, and the difference will be taken. So this difference is, that means TF stands for final tension. Then this difference, either whether we have to add or subtract, it depends upon how we are getting this TI, whether we are getting negative value or positive value. So this is how the experiment is performed, that I will be explaining. So what you can see, this is the setup diagram, this is the free body diagram, and we need the values for calculations. So we need W1, W2, X1, X2, TI and TF, and also this Y. Y is fixed. This is the moment value. The value of Y I was mentioning is this distance. This is distance is required. Now if you see this free body diagram, we will come to little calculation part. If you see this free body diagram, now what are the various forces, or let me draw the free body diagram separately. Just one second. Yeah. Now if I draw the free body diagram, suppose I have added two weights, W1 and W2. So because of this weights, there will be tension in the string T. And this distance is Y from this O, and this is X1, and correspondingly this is X2. So if we look at this equilibrium diagram, free body diagram, there are three forces. Now out of these three forces, this W1 and W2 are creating clockwise moment with respect to origin. You can see these are creating clockwise moment, and only tension, which is actually balancing these two forces, is creating the counterclockwise moment or anticlockwise moment. So therefore, if I write down the clockwise moments, what are the total clockwise moment? So moment is defined as force into perpendicular distance. So clockwise moment is created because of W1, and this is the moment because of W1 and W2. So this is multiplication, the total moment because of W1 and W2. So I am assuming for clockwise, I am assuming the plus sign. One can assume the other way also. Only tension is creating the anticlockwise moment. So anticlockwise moment is created by tension. The distance is Y. So whether this value is balancing this value or not, this we have to check for an equilibrium system. So now we will go to the setup, and we will see how it is performed, and we will note down the readings, and we will verify the law of moment. So as we were discussing, this is the bell crank lever setup. So with the help of this setup, we will be verifying the law of moment. So the law of moment we have already discussed. So it states that the total clockwise moment is equal to the total anti-clockwise moment. So it is applied for body which is under equilibrium because of various forces. So it is similar to Varinus theorem. So Varinus theorem, if you recall, it states that the total moment because of various forces that are acting on the body which is in equilibrium is equal to the moment of the resultant. So this is the law of moment, is the other way of saying the Varinus theorem. So the total anti-clockwise moment will be equal to the total clockwise moment for an equilibrium system. So that we will be verifying with the help of this bell crank lever setup. So we have this setup. Now we will look at the apparatus. This is the lever, this is the bell crank lever we call. Now this bell crank lever is connected to the base. So we will assume that it is rigidly supported here. So it is connected to this base via this chain. So there is a spring. Now this will be helpful to know the tension which is coming in the spring. So this will give us the reading in terms of, it will give in terms of kg. So the other apparatus, we need minimum two weights are required. Now the experiment is performed, like we'll be adding weights here. So at any location from this pivot point, so from here we can add the weights, any number of weights we can add, and at any distance we can add to verify that. So what will happen is, once we add the weight here, so the system will definitely be in equilibrium because this base is rigidly supported, and this weight is also balanced by the tension which is coming in the string here. Okay, so how the moments are taken, that means we have to take the clockwise moment and we need to equal that to the anti-clockwise moment. So we need to understand that means once we add the loads here, the loads are directed downwards. The direction of the load will be vertically downwards. So we'll prefer to take moment at this point. So we should understand that the moment can be taken at any arbitrary point, but it is better to take the moment here because we can find out the distances from respective force, line of action of the forces. So once we add the forces here, the forces will be directed in the downward direction. So if I take
moment about this point because of these forces, say for example two forces, then that moment will be, it will be in the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction depending upon which side you are looking. So see, I will look it from, you can say from this side. If I look it from this side, then what will be the direction? The direction will be clockwise. Okay, the moment direction will be clockwise for these forces. And now what are the total forces that are coming on the body? So two forces we have added here and another force is here. So this force is nothing but the tension. Okay, so that I have explained already in the free body diagram. Okay, so this another force, which is the tension, this is creating anti-clockwise moment with respect to this point. So this is what we need to check by applying the load, whether this force which is creating the anti-clockwise moment, this moment is equal to the clockwise moment because of these two forces. So what we will do, what we will do now is we will put some loads at different points. Okay, so I have a few loads here with me. This is 1 kg load, and these are small weights are added here. This is totally becoming half kg. Okay, so at any point we can add. Just important thing is, before we add the weights, there may be some already tension in the string that we need to check, and whether any initial tension is there or not, and that we need to consider at the during the calculations. And also this needs to be aligned properly, this point and this point needs to be aligned properly, because see, we will be taking this vertical distance to calculate the moment, and this vertical distance, once we are taking this vertical distance, so this has to be properly aligned, because force, I mean moment, is calculated as force into perpendicular distance, so this would be perpendicular. So that is the reason why we need to align this. So for alignment we have this adjustment, we can use this for alignment, or we can directly use these slots in the chain for quick alignment. I will just assume that it is properly aligned. I will check for any initial tension is there in the string or not. I will note down initial tension as 1.5 kg. Then I will be adding the weights at different locations. These are random random loads we can add at random distances, and same thing we can alter for different readings. So I have added the loads, this is 1 kg and this is half kg load. Now I will check out the distance where I have added the loads, but before again I do the calculations or I measure the tension, the final tension in the string, I have to align this, I have to align this lever exactly perpendicular to these forces. Again, that can be done with the help of this setup. So I am just doing that alignment. Okay, now it is almost properly aligned. Now the final tension I will note down, that is 4.3 kg. Okay, so I will note down those readings. The final tension in the string, now this 4.5 kg tension is balancing these loads. So now these loads are added, 1 kg and half kg. We will note down the distances, there is a scale given. So with the help of this we can note down. So this is 1 kg is added at 29.5 cm, 1 kg is added at 29 cm, and half kg is added at 55 cm. So we can do the calculations either in centimeters or in millimeters. So I will just brief again, once again, that the setup required, we need two weights, spring is required, and a bell crank lever. This is good enough to verify law of moment, which states that the total anti-clockwise moment or the clockwise moment is equal to the anti-clockwise moment created by this tension. Now we will do the calculations and we will see whether this value is balancing this value or not for an equilibrium system. So we will see that in the calculations.
So we have noted down the readings. If you look at the observation table, we have added two weights. So W1 is 1 kg, the other weight we had added is 0.5 kg. The corresponding distances from the point where we take the moment is 29 centimeters for W1 and 55 centimeters for W2. The initial tension was observed as 1.5 kg. The final tension after adding these two weights was observed as 4.5 kg. So the net tension is 3 kg. Now we need this values, and we can keep these weights in kgs and the distance is centimeters. Now if we look at the free body diagram, which we have already discussed, so there will be tension in this direction. So this T is now 3, which is the difference of final minus initial tension. So two weights we have added, W1 and W2. So these are the distances, corresponding distances. Now we will take moment of all these forces with respect to O. So if we look at this system, W1 and W2 will create clockwise moment with respect to O, and only tension will create the anti-clockwise moment. So we have this distance x1, x2, we have this W1, W2 value, also we have this T value. Now for T, if we have to calculate moment, this distance is required from this to this, that is perpendicular distance, and that is 20 centimeters. This is it is a fixed value, this length is fixed and it is measured for our setup as 20 centimeters. Now if we do the calculations, the clockwise moment is created by W1 and W2, and if I take the total of it, so 1 kg, the distance is 29 centimeters, plus the other one is 0.5 kg, the corresponding distance, perpendicular distance, is recorded as 55. So this will come 29 plus 27.5, so 56.5 kg centimeters. Now anti-clockwise moment is created by only one force out of these three, that is tension. So we need to check the moment of that tension. Now the total tension is 3. I will write here anti-clockwise moment or counterclockwise. Now that is tension T into distance, which is Y, that is 20 centimeters. So it is 60 kg centimeters. So this is the anti-clockwise moment or counterclockwise moment for the equilibrium system. Only one force is creating that counterclockwise moment, and the two forces are creating clockwise moment. So if we compare this value and this value, there is a little difference. So this is what we had to verify. Actually, ideally, the two values should be exactly equal for an equilibrium system. That is what the law of moment states. The total clockwise moment should balance the total anti-clockwise moment when the system is in equilibrium. So here there is error because we have taken practical readings, and maybe there may be some error in the spring reading or the distances. So those will be there when we are taking some practical values. So due to practical readings, those errors will come. So this is the overall demonstration of the bell crank lever setup, and with the help of this setup we have verified the law of moment. There was some error, but the verification has been done with the help of bell crank lever setup. Thank you.